Now. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Well, good morning, everybody. We appreciate you coming this morning. I know it's a little different. Truthfully, I've never even been, as far as I know, to a drive-in theater. And it's the first time I've ever been to a drive-in church service. But I do appreciate the opportunity to get to see everybody, and we appreciate you coming and being a part this morning. Appreciate the Lord and everything He's doing for us and has done for us. And we're going to celebrate Easter or Resurrection morning today. And real quick, just a way of announcements, we've been kind of giving some updates. Want to continue to update you, the church, as far as the sanctuary goes. We are continuing the work there. The carpet's being laid now. They've got the sanctuary, basically they've got it laid. Now they're laying the up in the choir part, and so hopefully that should be finished first of the week, and after that they'll be moving on to the pews to be the thing after that. So we just appreciate all that that's taking place. Brother Steve, I don't know if he's here this morning, but he'd appreciate you. There he is, waving his hand out there. He'd appreciate you sending your tithes in if you hadn't been sending them in. He says to the church, and it is true, we still have to pay our bills, and so send your tithe money in, and we want to just encourage you to do that. Also, Brother Clayton has made some little crosses. I know there's going to be a lot of wind interference, but he's made some little crosses for anybody that would like to have one. And what we're going to do with these after the service today, we'll set a chair out here, and so you can drive by and pick you up one if you want one. But these is for anybody and everybody that would like one. It's just a cross representing what this day stands for, and our Christ and our Redeemer and Savior. And so I appreciate him doing that. And so if you're able to do that, come by and get one of those, and we'll set that out after service this morning. And once again, we just appreciate all of you coming and being a part. It's good to get to see a lot of you. We haven't get to see a lot of folks now, the way things are, but we just appreciate you being here this morning. They're going to play an instrumental or two for us. We're going to have a song, and then I'll preach to us for just a few minutes, and after that, that'll be it. But I do appreciate you coming this morning and being a part. Thank you. don't have an Easter song this morning, but I do have a promising song here. Whenever you're down and out and you got nowhere to go, always remember, God's on the mountain waiting on you. Life is easy when you're up on a mountain. You got peace of mind like you never known. But then things change and you're down in the valley. At his best, but it's down in the valley of trials and temptations. That's when faith is really put to the test. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. So easy when life's at its best, but it's down in the valley of trials and temptations. That's when faith is really put to the test. It's a God on the mountain. He's still got it. Instrument for us, and then after that I'll try to preach to us. Once again, let me say how much I appreciate all the help that went in this morning getting our service going, and all of the effort everybody made to try to get this out this morning. We just appreciate that. I appreciate Jessica for getting everything on Facebook for us, and she's also got a service on YouTube, and she's going to try to get the rest of them we've had on YouTube also for those that can't watch them in that way, so you can see them in that area. If you'd like to look at them, you'd be more than welcome to go back and hunt those up. And it's also on the church's website. If you'd like to go there, you can find it there also and see there. And we just appreciate all the effort and help that's went for everything that we're doing. appreciate you being here. I'd like to turn in my Bible this morning to the, if you have yours, you can turn also if you'd like to, in the book of Philippians writing, in the 4th chapter. I'd like to talk to us for just a little while. I won't be very long-winded, but we will just try to give you that. I felt like the Lord wanted us to say this morning, and I do appreciate the Lord. But in the 4th chapter of the book of Philippians writing, I'd like to skip down to verse number 7 and maybe talk out of this verse something I feel like the Lord laid upon our hearts. The scripture says in chapter number 4 of the book of Philippians writing, verse number 7 says, "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus." If you would stretch your hands this way this morning, or bow your heads, or however you're able to do this morning, let's ask God to touch His word and anoint it. Great God in heaven, we just love you, honor, and glorify you. Thank you for your mercies and for your blessings. God, we thank you for the opportunity that we have to be gathered in this house or the way we are this morning. Christ, we know that this is not the usual order that we do things in, but we know that you're still Lord God and Savior this morning. We give you all the honor and all the glory. God, I ask that you would touch hearts and minds this morning, God, to encourage and strengthen us. God, if they'd be one that's lost and undone, Jesus, they would find you, Jesus. Know that you are the eternal hope of this lost and dying world. We'll give you all the honor and all the glory. It's in your holy name we pray. Amen and amen. I mentioned this morning in the scripture, in the text that I wrote to or read to us, it talks about a peace of God that there is. I think in these troubling times that we're in now, with times that are going on, the things that are happening, you can tell people's minds are not at peace anymore. They're stirred. There are troubles in our lands, the things that's taking place with the coronavirus. And not just that, there are all other problems that men and women are having. The things that they're battling, the things that they're going through. And so the minds of people are tormented. There's no peace seeming like in man anymore. No matter what he does or no matter the things that he accomplishes, there's no seemingly no peace. It doesn't mean there can't be joy. It doesn't mean there can't be some happiness. We all have good times. We all have bad times. We go through struggles. We're ups and downs. All those things are true in life. But there is a peace that a man can find in Jesus Christ that gives him a peace, whether it's in a good time or it's in the bad times. It gives him peace of mind and peace of heart, no matter the situations of life and the things that are going on and the things that surround him, the things that are taking place. The COVID-19 has a lot of people upset and stirred up, but truth be told, Christ lets us know that there's a peace that we can find in him, to know that no matter what happens in this life, afterwards, there's eternal life. And in Jesus Christ, we can find that peace this morning. And that's what we celebrate as this Easter morning, is the resurrection of Jesus Christ, the peace that he brings to mankind, the peace that he has for us. He doesn't necessarily bring happiness. He doesn't necessarily bring sadness. Those are emotions that's given by God. There's going to be in everybody's lives, no matter whether he's a sinner man, no matter whether he's a Christian this morning, his situation of life, rich or poor, in health or out of health, all those emotions and those things are going to take place. But the one thing that can be always in a man's life that knows Jesus Christ is a peace that he has with God, to know that all things are settled on this life or the life to come, that we have made things sure and right with our Savior and with Christ, that when this life is over, that all things are still good. We all do have troubles and trials. I looked up the word peace, and you can find different definitions of it, but the biblical definition, in the Hebrew word, it means shalom, but that word peace means also harmony, wholeness, soundness, or well-being. In other words, it's a perfection in our minds, in our thoughts. In the book of Genesis, writing in the 1st chapter and 31st verse, the scripture lets us know that God said, "And God saw everything that he had made." And this is after he created the world, after he created heavens and the earth, after he created the animals and the fish, all those things, man had been created. And said that God looked down upon it, And he said, and he said that, behold, it is very good, or it was very good. He looked upon this earth. No sin had entered into earth at this time. All things were still pure. So God looks down upon the earth, and he says, it's very good. In other words, he's implying there, or it's made implied there, that there's a peace on the earth, that there's a peace in everything that's taking place and all things that are going on, that there was a peace. And mankind can obtain under this peace. He's able to have the peace that God speaks about. In the book of Matthew's writing this morning, I'll read just a few verses to us about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Most all of us knows the story of Christ. We know that he came to this world, was born of a virgin, that he was born in a manger or in a lowly stable, in a low estate. He didn't come in royal. He didn't come in all greatness for mankind to see, but he simply came as a babe in a manger. He came as one that had to have the help of a mother and of a father. He came of one that was not notary. If you'll look through scripture, it lets us know that as Christ growed up and his life was, that he was not a man of proudness. He was not a man of good-looking character. He was not a man that was noted above anybody else, but he was simply a man that came, God that came in man form. And he lived upon this earth for those 30-some-odd years that he was here. And then after that, we know that the story begins to lead us to the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Most all of us know the story of the crucifixion, how that Jesus Christ was brought. He came to the garden, how the guards come, they take him in, they carry him before the trials, and they carry him before the judgment, and how that is offered unto him what would become of him, and the crowd begins to cry, crucify him, crucify him. And so on this past Friday, Good Friday, that we celebrate, it was that crucifixion of our Jesus and of our Christ and of our Lord and our Savior that takes place. And mankind looks at that and they say, well, why would a God do such things? Why would a God, if he is true and if he's real, if there is a true God, and if there is a true salvation, why would he come? Why would he die? Why would he live such a miserable life? Well, when you study scripture and look at the plan of salvation, we begin to realize why. It's so that me and you could inherit eternal life. It's so that me and you could have a peace with God. And that peace of God could only come through the Lamb, Jesus Christ, through our Lord and through our Savior. I preached last week on justification. In other words, being justified through Jesus Christ. He is the only hope for lost and dying humanity. A man that does not have Christ in his life cannot truly have the peace that I'm talking about this morning. My life may be in turmoils at times. There's times that I get frustrated. There's times that I get aggravated. There's times that I'm sad. There's times that things are not going my way. But I can honestly stand before you and tell you this morning that there is a peace in Jesus Christ. To know that if this world was to end for me today, if things would come to an end, that I would spend eternity in heaven this morning. To know that there is a Redeemer and a Savior, and his name is called Jesus Christ. In that 28th chapter, though, in the book of Matthew's writing, it comes to the time, it says in verse number 1, in the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. In other words, they had come to see where they had buried Christ. They had come to see where they had laid him. In verse number 5 it says, and the angel answered and said unto the women, fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. And then he says, he is not here, for he is risen. As he said, come and see the place where the Lord lay. And so I'd like to just tell you this morning that the only peace that a man can find is in a resurrected Savior and a resurrected Jesus Christ. He is the hope of those that are lost and dying this morning. He is the hope of the one and only. In the book of Romans writing, in the 4th chapter, verse number 24, it says, but for us also to whom it shall be imputed, if we believe on him that raised up Jesus our Lord from the dead, who was delivered for our offenses and was raised again for our justification. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. So he is the only peace that a man can have. In the book of Ephesians, writing in the second chapter, real quick, in the 11th verse, it says, wherefore remember that ye being in time past Gentiles in the flesh, who are called uncircumcision by that which is called circumcision, in the flesh made by hands, that at that time ye were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenant of the promise, having no hope and without God in this world. But now in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were afar off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, who hath made us both one and hath broken down the middle wall of partition between us. In other words, this morning, church, Jesus Christ is the only peace that a man can have in his life. It doesn't mean he can't live a good life without him. It doesn't mean that he can't be happy at times. It doesn't mean that he can't go through this life and suffice and make do and get by. But the truth is, there's no peace in his life. There's no true happiness that is really there. But that only comes by a resurrected Savior, Jesus Christ. And the plan was put into effect over 2,000 years ago. The salvation has now been given to every man, woman, boy, or girl, whosoever dies. God said, for he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. And glory to God, that's the hereafter. That's the life after this life. Once appointed unto man to die, and after this, the judgment. But I'm talking about in this life that we're living today. We can have peace of mind. We can have joy in our hearts. No matter the storms that rage around us, and no matter the troubles of life that might be occurring, there's a peace found in Jesus Christ this morning, church. There's a hope for you that if you're lost and dying, in this world this morning, if you got troubles and you can't rest at night, and there's no peace of heart and peace of mind, glory to God, there is a peace that a man can find. I can lay my head down at night, no matter the storms around me, no matter about the coronavirus, no matter about the things that are taking place, and I can find sweet rest and peace in Jesus Christ, and it gives me the sleep that I've been craving and looking for. That only comes through a resurrected Savior. That only comes through a risen Christ this morning, church. This world's in trouble. There's trouble all abounds and all around us. But I want you to know this morning, there is peace in the midst of the storm. There is peace in the midst of our troubles. There's peace no matter what you're facing or what you're going through. And that peace is found in Jesus Christ, the Lord, the King, the Redeemer, the Savior this morning. He is our hope. He is the Messiah. He is the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. He is that one that we need in times of troubles, times of heartaches. We can cry unto him, and he gives us a peace that is that we can't comprehend this morning. Word of God lets us know we can't comprehend that peace that he gives to us. How can a man that's lost his wife? How can a man that's lost his crop? How can a man that's lost a child? Or vice versa, children lose parents. People get sick and people die. But glory to God, there's a peace that can be found in Jesus Christ this morning. What is it? To know that I've been born again, to know that I've been saved and I've been redeemed by the love, by the blood of the Lamb and the Savior Jesus Christ. There is hope for you this morning, church. If you don't have that peace, it's available unto you. All you have to do is cry out and call upon him, and he is just to forgive us of our sins and to save our souls this morning. Glory to his name. He is a redeemer. He is a savior. Jesus Christ comes to this earth. He approaches the river. John the Baptist is baptizing. He looks up and he sees him walking, and he says, behold the Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. In other words, what was he saying? He says, behold the perfect sacrifice. That one that must die. Jesus Christ has already died for your sins. He's not going to do it again. He's not going to do it the second time. He's already come to this world. He's already walked upon. He's already gave His life for me and you. They couldn't take His life, but He tells them at the crucifixion, only that I give it unto you, and He willingly gives it unto us that we might have peace this morning, church. People's going to always have troubles. I know this is going out over the airwaves, and I know you get a lot of scrutiny from those and things you might say, but I'm going to be truthful with you this morning. I'm going to just be straight. Man dies. People have troubles. Good people die. Somebody said, they was doing it jokingly, that they said, well, you're anointed. They said, you won't die of the coronavirus. I said, no. There's people that's anointed of God that's dying of the coronavirus. Yeah. There's people dying of cancer. Anointed men of God and women of God. They are those that are saved and undone. They lose their children in accidents. There's those that are saved this morning. They face troubles in their families. They got children that's on drugs. There's those that are saved this morning. They're facing all kinds of trials in their lives. But don't you know there's a peace of God that comes unto man. There's a peace of God for those that are saved. I know of a preacher, he told me a story. His wife, I've mentioned this to the church, they've heard it, but some of you may not. They had a son that was in troubles. Son was not saved as far as they knew. This was a man and woman of God that had served the Lord for years and years, had done their best, tried to raise their children right. They said that their son died in a motel room in a bathroom, in a bathtub. They said that mother, it just worried her and her mind was upon that all the time. It just tore her up, the things that was going on, and it's just her imagination running wild and her imagination running with the things that could have happened and what might have took place and how he might have died. All those things was taking place. But it said that one day that she knelt before God and she cried out unto Him. And she said from her words, not that God told her that he was saved or lost. Not that God said that he died this way or that way. But see, God spoke a word of peace in her heart and her mind. And said that pressure that she had before, all those thoughts, all those things, he take and he wiped them away. This Jesus Christ is able to take away the things of this life and give us a peace in the midst of our storms, in the midst of our trials. He's able to help us this morning. That is the reason of the resurrection. It is so that we could be saved. This was the purpose that Christ came for. This was the real reason. You can look through the Word of God. You can find wonderful miracles that Jesus performed. He raised them from the dead. He brought those that were blinded. He made them to see. He made those that were deaf to hear. He made the lame to walk again. All those wonderful miracles that he done. All those great things. But when you read and study the Word of God, you'll find out that all those were just benefits that came along. The one and only reason that Jesus Christ came to this earth was to save mankind, to be the Lamb of God, to take away the sins of the world, to go to the cross and to die thereon and to be rose the third day from a power from God, that he would be resurrected. And Scripture lets us know if we'll just believe that in our hearts and we'll confess that with our mouths that we shall be saved. You can have a peace like you've never had before. And that peace only comes through a resurrected Savior this morning and a resurrected Jesus Christ. I encourage you as I'm closing. I encourage you, if you don't know the peace of God, that you seek it, you find Him. See, the wonderful thing this morning about God, you don't have to do it here at Eastside. You don't have to do it at the church down the road. We want you to do it here. They want you to do it there, wherever you can find the help. But all you have to do is call out to God wherever you're at, whether you're in a vehicle this morning, whether you're in a field somewhere, whether you're at home, whether you're in a nursing home or a hospital. All you have to do is cry out unto Christ and cry out unto God. and He will make you that son of God that He has promised. He will forgive you of your sins and redeem you. He will place in you a peace that surpasses all things that you've ever known. He'll give you a peace. He says that is unspeakable. We can't imagine, or you can't imagine that peace that God can give you to take away the worries and the things of this life. That says that I know that I'm saved, that I've been born again, that when this life is over, that I have an eternal home in heaven. And that comes through Jesus Christ this morning. And that comes through a resurrected Savior. And we celebrate that this morning. We celebrate this day as what it represents, that Jesus Christ rose from the grave. Real quick, and I'm going to let you go. I believe after Jesus Christ resurrected, I've done this study years ago, so it's a little bit, I'm just having to remember a little bit, but I believe after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, I believe it's recorded through the Bible and then through secular history, I believe there was over 400 people that saw Him before He ascended back to heaven. Over 400 people laid eyes upon this man that they had hung on a cross, on this God that they had sacrificed. And He completed that plan of salvation when He rose from that grave. And He ascended back to heaven. And Scripture lets us know today that He sits on the right hand of the Father. And the reason that He sits there is so that He can make intercession. In other words, He can make a go-between me and God. My way to God is through Jesus Christ. It is my way of eternal salvation. It is my way of eternal peace. Is found in Jesus Christ. I appreciate you this morning. I appreciate everybody for coming and being a part. I am sorry the way the services are having to be done right now. I understand we're trying to abide by what they want, the things that they say. But I still know that they're not in charge and that God's in charge of this world and is in charge of everything that is there. And He can give us that peace of heart. I appreciate you this morning. I appreciate everybody for coming, being a part, for everybody for listening. We thank you for coming and being this morning. If you would like a cross for anybody that would like one, we're going to take a chair and we'll set it out here. And just take your time. And if you leave by, if you'll stop and pick up one, it's just a representation. It's just we're showing this world. We're showing our God and our Savior. I understand it's a hard thing. I understand we live it. But if you'd like one of these crosses, it is that representation of Jesus, our protector, our Savior, and our God. I appreciate you this morning for coming and being a part of everybody. Thank you very much.